Hamming code is the topic for today's session. In this session, we shall discuss SecDec method or Hamming code. The full form of SecDec method is single error correction, double error detection method. So we are going to discuss this Hamming code. Before going for this Hamming code, let me discuss the parity bit. What is the parity bit? And then we shall go for the Hamming code in details. So now parity bit can be of two types. One is the even parity and another one is the odd parity. Now what is the parity bit in that case? Let us suppose sender is trying to send some data to the receiver. The data might be say 1101. So data is 1101. So through the transmission link, it is getting conducted or transmitted, and now the receiver should get the required message. But the receiver may get the corrupted one. So how this receiver can get the idea whether the message received by him or her is correct or wrong? So in that case, what we shall do, we shall go for the parity bit. Let us consider the even parity. Obviously, the odd parity will have the reverse logic. In case of even parity, the total number of 1 including the parity bit, so I shall attach another extra 1 parity bit, either it will be 0 or 1. In case of even parity bit, the total number of 1 in the message and the parity bit will be even. Obviously, in case of odd parity, total number of 1 in the message and the parity bit will become odd. So now let us consider the even parity here in our example. So 1101, so how many 1s are there? 3 1s. So to make even number 1 means 4 1s, I shall have to make this one 1. So here with this 1101, I am transmitting the even parity bit 1. So 1 is getting transmitted. At the receiving end, we are going to get, we are going to get the bit pattern say 1001 and this particular parity bit 1. So you see this particular bit has got corrupted due to some impairment. It has got corrupted. So what will happen? The receiver will regenerate the parity bit from its message bits in the same logic, even parity again. So it is 1001. So how many 1s are there? 2 1s. So to keep the total number of 1 in the message and the parity bit even, I should make a 0. So that total number of 1 will be 2, that is the even number of. So the received parity bit and the regenerated parity bit will be compared. And you see there is a mismatch. So from this, it will get the idea, the receiver will get the idea that the data has got corrupted during transmission. So that is the logic of the parity bit. But one limitation of parity bit here is that, let us suppose the transmitted data was 1101 and after receiving, it has become say 1011. So what happened? Two bits have got corrupted. This 1 has become 0 and this 0 has become 1. And obviously, along with this, the parity bit has been obtained. During transmission, the parity bit may also get corrupted. So now what will happen? If you consider the even parity for this, we are having 3 1s. So what will be the other bit to make even number of 1? 4 1s, 1. So the received parity bit and the regenerated parity bit, they are equal to each other. So that will indicate that my data has not been corrupted, but my data is highly corrupted. Two bits have got corrupted. So that is a limitation of parity bit. So what is the limitation of parity bit? If bit corruption takes place in even number of places, in 2 places, in 4 places, in 6 places, in 8 places, so if bit corruption takes place in even number of places, then parity bit cannot detect that error. So that is the main limitation of parity bit. So to resolve this particular scenario, we are going to introduce a technique known as the SecDec method or Hamming code. So let me discuss that one into details. Let us suppose we are having a message consisting of 8 data bits. D6, 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. So let us suppose we are having 1 byte of information. Now here from the receiver, from the sender, so D8 to D1, to the receiver. So let it be D8 dash to D1 dash. Don't consider them, I'm considering them as complement, not that. D8 dash to D1 dash. Here I shall attach, say, another 3 parity bits, say P3, P2, P1. So the received parity bits are P3 dash, P2 dash and P1 dash. I'm just giving you one example, only to indicate that what is the SecDet method, only to show you. It is not official. I'm just giving the example. Later we shall go for the rigorous calculation. So now here you see we are having 8 data and 3 parity bits. And these parity bits are being calculated from partial number of data bits in the event parity logic. Do you know what is the event parity generator circuit? In our digital electronics classes we have learned. So using XOR gate. Let me explain. So let us suppose my data is 1101. What is the event parity? 3 ones. What is the event parity? 1. So now please go on XORing. 1 XOR 1. What is that? 1 XOR 1. 1. This XOR 1. So 0 XOR 1. What is that? Sorry. 1 XOR 1 is 0. 0 XOR 0 is 0. And then 0 XOR 1. You are getting 1. So you see this bit is same as with this bit. So you know in case of XOR logic, same bits will produce output 0 and unequal bits will produce output 1. So 0 0 and 1 1 will produce 0 and 0 1 and 1 0 will produce 1 as output. So 1 1 means 0, 0 XOR 0 0, 0 XOR 1 1. So you see the logic is nothing but XORing all the data bits. So that is the logic. Now here in this case what we are doing, here we shall take the partial number of data bits. Say I'm taking arbitrarily this one. Obviously there will be some logic, but for the demonstration only I'm just taking that, I'm taking partial number of bits. So we are taking this 5, 4, we are taking this D3 and we are taking this say D2. Arbitrarily I have taken arbitrarily. Okay, now see, these parity bits are there which will be transferred, not a single parity bit, a bunch of parity bits which will be transferred along with the data bits. And these parity bits are getting generated from the partial data bit participation. So I'm not taking all the data bits for P3, P2 or P1 calculation. I've taken some of them. Now what will happen? In this way, I shall send 8 plus 3 bits and then I shall get 8 plus 3 bits. Then from this received data bits, these are data bits, parity bits, data bits and parity bits. So from the received data bits, I shall recalculate the parity bits using the same data association logic. So I shall get P3 dash dash, P2 dash dash, P1 dash dash. Please try to get me. So the logic in which this P3, P2, P1 was obtained, the bit association logic, the same logic I shall be using to calculate this P3 dash dash, P2 dash dash and P1 dash dash. Now this received parity bits and the regenerated parity bits will be XORed. The value thus obtained will be known as syndrome. The value thus obtained will be known as syndrome. We know that if all the bits are equal, respective bits, in case of XOR logic, if both of them are 1 or both of them are zeros, then in that case the syndrome will become 0 and it indicates no error. But let us suppose the syndrome is 011, so it indicates error. Please tell me what is 011 means 3 and it is error at D3. So it will indicate it is error at D3. So non-zero syndrome will indicate that error has occurred. And the value, decimal equivalent, will indicate that which bit has got corrupted. So as a result of that, I can easily correct my D3. How do you do the correction? What is the meaning of the term corruption? 1 cent, zero received, or 0 cent, one received. Then in the received bits, in the D3 will be replaced by its complemented value. So get back my original message. So that is the basic theme behind this SEC method. So single error correction. So you see, single error correction, that means it is sitting at the receiving end. I know my data has got corrupted because the syndrome is non-zero. I can correct the syndrome. I can get my data back. So I should not request. There is no need to request to the sender, please resend the data because your previous data sent got corrupted. So this is the logic in which we'll be doing that one officially. Okay. So what are the questions we are having are coming in our mind? That how many parity bits should be there? Here we have taken for 8 bits of data, 3 parity bits. Is it so? Or I should take 4 bits or 5 bits for the parity? So how many parity bits should I take? Second question is coming in mind. How to form the parity bits? That means what will be the data bit association? It is also not mandatory that all these parity bits will have the same number of data bits. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. It is not mandatory. It can have some unequal number of data bits also. So we should know this, how these parity bits can be formed. And then how data and parity bits will be arranged. Should I send these parity bits at the end of the data? Or should I send these parity bits before the data? Or should I mix them up, these data bits and parity bits? So that is the third question is coming in our mind. And the fourth question, how officially the SEC method is working and how officially the DET method is working. So this is the sum up. So here I've given a simple example only to make the idea clear, what is the syndrome and what is the inference if the syndrome is zero and if the syndrome is non-zero. So I've given this particular example for this. So in the next video, we shall go into the details, the official formalities for the SEC method. Please watch the next video as a continuation. Thank you.